I was driving up the 101 passing San Francisco International Airport one day, coming back from San Jose, and I was watching a 747 take off, which was going to, you know, an international destination, which is later I found out the direction they fly for that. And I was watching the plane instead of the road, and I almost got in an accident. And I think that was the nail in the coffin, the spearhead that really gained my interest. One interesting factor on my typical day is your day is anything but typical. I've heard a lot of people say that the flight attendant is a glorified waiter or waitress. And that's 90% of what we do when the public sees us. But typically we can be on the airplane up to an hour and a half before the public even boards. We'll do a bomb sweep of the airplane looking for anything that looks out of the ordinary. We're looking for anything that might be considered hazardous materials, as well as people. Some of the things we're looking for, essentially, is, of course, certain profiles of people. American society in general, I think, is very arrogant as far as the ways of the world, and especially when you consider the security risks and threats that the America receives every day. But I think that America, in general, is pretty lax about its security measures. But I feel that the airlines have done a superb job so far. That goes completely against everything that a crew is trained for. But in reality, how do you prepare yourself for every contingency? Flight crew's training, before September 11th, consisted of stalling the hijackers, coinciding with most of their demands that were, you know, of course, reasonable. To stall the hijackers long enough so the authorities could figure out what they were going to do. This instance, as far as September 11th, was completely an 180-degree turn from that. I'm working for the company whose paint job is painted on this airplane hitting the South Tower. And I think, my God, that is a United 767. It's a United airplane. And I was looking at that, and just having it being shown again and again and again really began to get imprinted in my mind. Once I had made peace with the fact that I had lost brothers, you know, brothers and sisters who had the same job as me, I began to think that they would want me to continue. Everybody really banded together and really wanted to be there for everyone else. I mean, people that didn't even know your name would come up to you and give you a hug just because you're wearing the uniform. What was actually very interesting is when I was doing my safety demo after September 11th, and you know, this is how you buckle your seatbelt, these are the exits, things like that. For the first time in my 16 months of flying up until then, that people actually were watching you. People were actually listening. People weren't getting mad at you because they couldn't concentrate on what they were reading on, like their newspaper, while you were telling them how to egress from the airplane and evacuation. People weren't doing that anymore. And it was amazing. People are taking their safety more seriously. But it's a tragedy in itself that it takes this to open people's eyes like that. Don't underestimate the person that's doing something for you. Don't underappreciate those people that are next to you, because you might, you never know when they won't be there anymore. And especially if you're going to be flying, respect that person that's helping you in that uniform.